Today, for us and the planet, the vision of inclusive green recovery towards carbon neutrality invites us all to pull our wisdom together, act together, practice together, as the spirit that defines P4G. Through this summit, I hope the history of humanity will transform into a history of coexistence.
We were robbed of our forest resources by other nations, and we were left to cut down trees for firewood or industrial fuel.
Yet, the people of Korea brought our nature back to life. We planted trees on barren mountains, reduced waste, and took action to save nature. And as a result, in a short span of only 20 years, as we embarked on forest restoration, the UNFAO recognized Korea as the only developing country in the world after World War II that has achieved great success in forest reclamation.
We have all realized that we cannot fight with nature. We have to make nature an ally of development. And I think that is the only model which can work as we go into the 21st century. In Pakistan, we realized this during the COVID era, and we announced what was called the Green Stimulus. The idea was to put the country onto a pathway of green development and green growth. During the COVID era, this Green Stimulus was focused on three things. Firstly, we had the 10 billion tree plantation initiative in place, and we pushed it further to create more green jobs for people who were out there in nature, creating nurseries, protecting forests from wildfire, and nurturing forests towards natural regeneration. And we have a target of restoring over 1 million hectares of forest by 2023.
안녕하십니까. Mesdames et messieurs, les chefs d'État et de gouvernement, Monsieur le Président Moon, cher ami, la France, l'Union européenne, de nombreux autres pays se sont en effet engagés à la neutralité carbone à échéance 2050. C'est ce plan que l'Union européenne a mis sur la table, avec l'objectif de réduction des émissions de 55% en 2030 par rapport à 1990. Et le fameux Green Deal pour lui donner corps.
Excellencies, friends, I thank President Moon Jae-in and the government of the Republic of Korea for hosting this year's P4G Summit. The title of this initiative expresses exactly what the world needs now, global partnership. Partnership to beat COVID-19 and build a better recovery. Partnership to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals and partnership to address climate change.
A key part of Canada's plan to achieve its climate goals is the commitment to phase out the use of thermal coal by 2030. The phase out of thermal coal, which is responsible for 20% of global emissions, is the single most important step the world can take to meet Paris' goal.
Daher setzen wir in Deutschland auf eine CO2-Bepreisung, und zwar neben den Sektoren Energie und Industrie, auch bei Verkehr und Wärme. Bei allem, was wir dafür tun, um unser nationales Ziel der Klimaneutralität bereits bis 2045 zu erreichen, wissen wir, die nachhaltige Reduktion von Treibhausgasemissionen kann nur global gelingen.
In response, it is essential to redesign our socio-economic system to make it sustainable and resilient. To this end, Japan is accelerating its efforts to make three transitions. We made our commitment to take decarbonization clear.
We need an end to dirty old coal, fueling our power grids, and we need governments that will not just make promises on climate and nature, but match those words with deeds.
This is the part you have all been waiting for. Yes, now it's time to announce the winner of P4G Seoul Summit Contest hosted by the Embassy of Republic of Korea in Pakistan. There was a video contest which was announced prior to the summit. Anyone was eligible to participate. And the requirement was to upload a maximum 3 minutes long review video of the summit explaining about what you learned from the summit and how it will bring global change. Many participants submitted their videos, and the best video which fulfilled all the requirements was chosen as a winner video. The person who won the contest is Mr. Zaheer Anwar.
Hi, this is Zaheer Anwar and welcome to this video. In this video, I will talk about Summit on Carbon Neutral Smart Water Management for Climate Resilience, which was hosted by Ministry of Environment of Republic of Korea and P4G Hub on 31st of May 2021.
Congratulations, Mr. Zaheer. You will be contacted by the team and your prize will be delivered to you soon. A special thanks to everyone who participated, and stay tuned for more interesting contests and events held by the Embassy of Republic of Korea in Pakistan.
Hi, my name is Hamza. P4G Seoul Summit 2021 was held on May 30th and 31st, 2021, in which many participants from Pakistan learned a lot. Thanks to Embassy of Republic of Korea in Pakistan for their efforts and creating awareness in Pakistani youth. They arranged a contest too, which again motivated many to attend this summit. P4G focused on public-private partnerships while making room for voices of civil society, children and youth. The first day of P4G Seoul Summit 2021 featured an opening ceremony with cultural performances and an address from Moon Jae-in, President Republic of Korea. This was followed by a leaders' session where speakers shared their views on inclusive green recovery towards carbon neutrality by 2050 and strengthening climate action and facilitating public-private partnerships. On strengthening climate action and facilitating public-private partnerships, many lauded the Republic of Korea's steps to strengthen the NDCs and urged similar action from others. The final day of P4G Seoul Summit 2021 began with 5 thematic breakout sessions on water, energy, agriculture, cities, and circular economy. The thematic session on carbon-neutral smart water management for climate resilience discussed good water governance in context of carbon neutrality and promoted partnerships and collaborations to achieve carbon-neutral water management. The session on greener planet with innovative energy solutions addressed low-carbon energy solutions to contribute to carbon-neutral growth. The resilient and sustainable agriculture and food systems thematic session explored strengthening and developing partnerships to enhance effective cooperation in agriculture and food sectors. The thematic session on partnership for smart and resilient green cities discussed the role of smart cities for green recovery, carbon neutrality, and climate crisis responses. The session on circular economy measures towards a zero-waste society addressed the latest global efforts, actions, and innovations in circular economy with special focus on zero waste. In the end, the leaders' dialogue featured heads of state and leaders sharing their national experiences for achieving an inclusive green recovery and carbon neutrality by 2050 and using public-private partnerships to strengthen climate action. The leaders adopted the Seoul Declaration without amendment. The declaration underscores inclusive green recovery, the importance of public-private partnerships, and the role of youth, urging everyone to act now for green future. Moon Jae-in, President Republic of Korea, closed the summit at 11:40 p.m. Korean Standard Time. Thank you.